मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स टू ऑनलाइन इंग्लिश स्टूडियो क्लास. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन चैप्टर नंबर 5 द मास्क. सो विदाउट वेस्ट ऑफ टाइम लेट अस बिगिन द क्लास एज इट इज गिवन इन योर बुक. चिल्ड्रन यू ऑल माय सजेशन इज दैट यू कैन ओपन योर बुक पेज नंबर 41 एंड देयर इज सम वर्ड्स गिवन इन रेड कलर. दीज आर द मीनिंग्स व्हिच इज ऑलरेडी गिवन इन योर बुक. सो आई विल एक्सप्लेन द मीनिंग, यू कैन फाइंड आउट इन योर बुक. सो प्लीज ओपन पेज नंबर 41 एंड ट्राई टू गेट दिस पैराग्राफ. So here says Feluda or Pradosh Chandra Mitra is an amateur sled who is a character in a series of Bengali detective fiction novels and short story which were written by Satyajit Ray. Okay, so student, here we got our writer whose name is Satyajit Ray. Okay, we just introduce the character of the story, that Feluda or Pradosh Chandra Mitra. Feluda और प्रदोष चंद्र मित्रा बोथ आर सेम पर्सन. ओके, ही इज अमेचर स्लेड. ओके चिल्ड्रन, अमेचर इज अ पर्सन हु इज समवेयर न्यू इन एनी जॉब एंड स्लेड इज अ डिटेक्टिव. सो फेलुदा इज नॉट अ डिटेक्टिव बाय हिज प्रोफेशन, इवन ही हैज इंटरेस्ट इन दैट. सो दैट इज वाई ही इज वर्किंग एज अ डिटेक्टिव इन दिस स्टोरी. ओके, ही मेक्स हिज फर्स्ट अपियरेंस इन दिस स्टोरी. And then Topsy is Feluda's cousin and the narrator of the story. Okay, children, we here got another character, that is Topsy. So Topsy is Feluda's cousin as and also the narrator of the story. He only narrates the story, so that we will familiarize of that. Okay. He accompanies Feluda on all his adventures. Feluda and Topsy are on holiday in Darjeeling when this incident occurs. So again we got one point from our story, that this story is basically based on Darjeeling. They are spending their holiday there, and then after they have the case, in that case they just wanted to investigate what had happened, and about which incident they are talking about. Okay, so let us see what is given in first stanza. I will make it bigger. Okay, yeah, so here it says that I had accidentally overheard a disturbing conversation between Rajan Babu and a friend of his when I was sitting in the mall, and had reported to Feluda that there seemed to be something to investigate. Okay, so here Topsy is saying that I had accidentally overheard a disturbing conversation between Rajan Babu and one of his friend. So here the main character of the story reveal, whose name is Rajan Babu. Okay, and he had a conversation with one of his friend. They both were in a mall. Okay, and they found, means when they heard the conversation, they found that there are something to investigate in between them. Okay, now second. Okay, in Rajan Babu, an amiable man. Amiable means a person who is very friendly in nature. So it's talking about the character that Rajan Babu is an amiable person, was living a peaceful retired life in Darjeeling. Recently he had taken a paying guest whose name is Tinkori Babu. Okay, so the friend I was talking in first stanza, whose name was Tinkori Babu, he is one of his friends, and now he is living with Rajan Babu at his home. On the recommendation of his dear friend, Tinkori Babu had a special weakness for cheroot. Okay, cheroot is such like a secret, we can say, that the people used to take. Before moving into Rajan Babu's house, he has completely taken the permission of him, and then after they both are living together. Okay, now paragraph 3. Yeah, now you can open page number 42. A few days ago, Rajan Babu had received a threatening letter by post. It had words not written but cut from the newspaper and book. Be prepared to pay for your sins. Is that all is said? Okay, so he has got a cutting page of a newspaper in which written that be prepared to pay for his to your sin. Okay, so that was a threatening letter that Rajan Babu got by post. Okay, then after in paragraph 4 you say that when we visited Rajan Babu to inquire about it, Feluda asked, have you a reason to suspect anyone? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. I don't remember harming anyone anytime. Does anyone visit you regularly? Well, I don't get too many visitors. Dr. Funi Mitra comes occasionally, but only when I become ill. Okay, so they ask that if anybody is there on whom you have any suspect, or anybody who regularly comes to you. So he told that no, generally do not, but Dr. Funi Mitra comes, so sometimes comes to me when I become ill. So he comes to me sometimes. Okay. After some investigation, Feluda said to me, Dr. Funi Mitra could be one who sent the letter. He seems to be in need of money, and he doesn't have a good practice. A letter like this would make Rajan Babu afraid and make him ill. And if that happened, he would naturally go to his doctor. So this is the this man is the first suspect in this story, whose name is Dr. Phoni Mitra. So Feluda and Topsy decided that this person can be one of the suspects, because his practice is not going well. So that is why he need his patient for his practice, for earning money. Okay. Now, paragraph 9. The second person who visited Rajan Babu often was Mr. Ghoshal, an expert in antiques. Of late, Rajan Babu had developed an interest in antiques and curious and collected many masks, daggers, old paintings. Okay, so there the second suspect who came into the view, whose name was Mr. Ghoshal. Mr. Ghoshal was an expert in antiques. Antiques means what? Collecting old material, but the old material is valuable. Okay, again given old and very valuable things. So now, before some time, Rajan Babu had great interest in that. So that is why he can also send the letter, so that he can have some benefit from him. Okay. Okay, paragraph number 10. Tinkori Babu thought Ghoshal was a crook. Children, crook means a person who is dishonest. Okay, who is crook? I don't trust on him at all. He pretends to be interested in art and antiques, but I think what he really wants to buy them cheap here and sell them in foreigners at a much higher rate. Okay, so Tinkori Babu had told Feluda when we met him in the cafe shop to the next day. Okay, so here they are talking about Mr. Ghoshal, that how he was a crook person, always so sell his antiques to the foreigners in a high rate. So he can also be one of the suspects. Okay. Then he might have a motto to sending the motto in sending the letter to Rajan Babu, said Feluda. I learned during my visit to the curio shop today that the shop is going to get some fresh supplies in this evening. I see, exclaimed Tinkori Babu. A letter like that would naturally frighten Rajan Babu into staying his home for a few days. And Mr. Ghoshal would get to buy all new pieces. So these are the suspicion. These are the reason they are just investigating into the matter. So these two names comes. Okay, exactly. Our next suspect was Rajan Babu's son, Prabir Majumdar, who was away. Rajan Babu, it seems, had asked Prabir to leave the house when he was caught stealing money from his father's cupboard. Father and son had not been in a contact since. Feluda's investigation had revealed that Prabir had recently arrived in Darjeeling. This is new shock to Tinkori Babu. So here they got their third suspect, whose name was Prabir Majumdar, who was the son of Rajan Babu. So actually he is not at his home. He has thrown away by his father because once he caught by stealing money from his cupboard. So that is why he can be also one of the suspect. And now he is found out in Darjeeling. So now the suspension regarding this man is increased. Okay. So now there are three suspects in this story we got in the very beginning of the stories. Now, paragraph 16. Let me make it bigger. It's very small or not coming clearly. Rajan Babu doesn't know that his son is in the town setting Kori Babu, and I don't think he should be told. After all, he's already had one shock. Okay, so Tinkori Babu suggested to both of the directives that we should not inform Rajan Babu that his son is here because he already got a shock, and after hearing this news, he becomes one more shock. That is why he will get something, means he becomes upset. So Prabir has a motto to threaten his father, interrupted Feluda. Now the case had reached the stage where it had three suspects but no culprit yet. Then something very frightening happened. One morning we receive a message to Rajan Babu. Rajan Babu wanted to see us urgently, and we rushed into his house, calling about that we received a call that Rajan Babu urgently wanted to meet us. So that is why we visited there. We found him lying down, looking pale and haggard. Okay, pale and haggard means very weak. Okay, pale and haggard is given in your book, page number 43. So it says that it is unusually white and tired due to worry and lack of sleep. Okay, so due to lack of sleep he becomes very weak and dried somewhere. Okay. Dr. Mitra was by his side examining him, and Tinkori Babu was fanning him. Rajan Babu spoke him with some difficulty. Last night after midnight I woke up suddenly. There it was. Face masked. Yes, I saw the masked face. It bent over me. It was horrible. Rajan Babu continued. I can't tell you how I spent the last night. So here he is talking about that I found a masked face who bent over me, and that is why the night was very horrible for me. I become afraid due to seeing that mask. Take it easy, said the doctor. You need complete rest. Dr. Mitra, Feluda said suddenly, did you go last night? Your jacket's got a streak of mud on it. Okay, streak means a long mask given in your book. So there is a mask on your jacket. So where you had been last night? Yes, I did to see a patient, replied Dr. Foni Mitra. Okay, so they just wanted to investigate. So that is why they are asking that types of question. Okay, now next paragraph. Okay, now just turn the page number 44, paragraph number 25. Okay, so Feluda waited for the doctor to leave and then asked Rajan Babu, what did the mask look like? It was like one of those masks you see on the wall there. The mask he pointed out was most horrible. So they were asking question that what about the mask? So he told that it was looking like the mask which were available at the wall of the next room. So he pointed out that mask which is the most horrible mask in among them. And then after Tinkori Babu came after seeing the doctor off and said to us, I'm sorry but I have to return to Calcutta today. I tried to change my ticket but they said I can't get a booking for another 10 days. But before I leave, I will inform the police. Rajan Babu needs protection. Fellow Babu, you can continue your investigation. Nobody will object to us. Okay, what happened here? Here we found that Tinkori Babu just wants to leave now the house, and he wanted to go Calcutta again. And he is saying that I wanted to inform police and wants to tell all the matter what is happening with my friend. So he told to Feluda that you can start your investigation what and nobody will object to you. Okay, Feluda and I decided to stay that night at Rajan Babu's house, and we then went out separately on our work for the rest for the day, and got back in the evening and to find Rajan Babu much better. He showed us to our room. Okay, so they both stayed there, and then after they are also working their work. Feluda stretched out on the bed and said, "I did some investigation in the afternoon, and both Prabir and Ghoshal were at party from 9 to 3 p.m. Okay, so they both were talking that they did investigation and they found that Prabir and Mr. Ghoshal, they both were at the party at the time of 9 to 3 a.m. So definitely they both were not the culprit, okay, because Tinkori Babu, Rajan Babu is talking about the midnight that the incident would happen. So they both were not there at his home. Okay, now the next 30, paragraph number 30. That man wearing a mask came here after midnight, didn't he? I asked. Yes, Feluda. Yes, said Feluda, and left the room abruptly. I lay on the bed and must have dozed off. I woke up with a jolt when I sensed the presence of someone else in the room. My blood froze. I opened my eyes and saw something coming towards me. Oh, how horrible it was. A masked face. Okay, now see what happened. Then after autopsy, saying that when I and Feluda were talking about this thing, then after I lay on the bed, and then after I become sleepy, and I woke up a jolt. A jolt means something shaking up, okay? Then I sense it. I feel there's a presence of somebody else in my room. I become horrible, okay? So my blood completely becomes cold. I freeze. I open my eyes, and then I found there was a mask coming towards me, a masked man, okay? A horrible masked man. I opened my mouth to scream when the person wearing the mask pulled it away, and my scream becomes a nervous gasp like that. Okay, Feluda, oh my god, isn't it you? So as soon as I was going to scream, I found that the masked man put out his mask from his face, and I got that he's Feluda who was wearing the mask. Okay, of course it's me. He raised the mask. It was trying on all the masks in the living room. Why don't you wear one of those for a second? He passed his mask. I wore it. Okay, he told to wear the mask for a second to him. And then after Topsy the narrator, so he told that I used it. Okay, can you sense something unusual? Why not? It's a size too large for me. That's all. Okay, he told that its size is very large. Think carefully. Isn't there anything that might strike you as odd? Okay, strike you as odd means make someone think that something is wrong. Well, there's a faint smell. I think, for what? Cheroot. Exactly. My heart started to beat faster again. Tinkori Babu, I stammered. Okay, I told. Feluda sighed. Yes, I am afraid so. But what I do not understand is, what is his motive? He seemed to respect Rajan Babu a lot. Why then he did so? Something like that. Perhaps we shall never know. Rajan Babu was absolutely shaken when we told him about this the next morning. As we were talking, Rajan Babu received the letter. He opened it with a trembling hand and then read aloud. Okay, he again got a letter. What is written in that letter? Dear Raju, if you are wondering who am I and why I did this, here is the story. I am the boy whom you had chipped in the 100-yard race. I will just read from the book. It is not coming clearly. Okay, so I will read from the book. So he is saying that I, if you are wondering who I am and why I did this, here is the story. I am the boy whom you had tripped in the 100-yard race on your sports day 50 years ago. So here he is talking about 50 years ago. Okay, 50 years ago when they were a boy. And he is talking about the 100-meter race. Okay. I not only missed the medal in that race, but was also seriously injured. Okay, he has missed his medal as well as got injured. Unfortunately, my father got transferred to a different town. Soon after the incident, I never got a chance to have a showdown with you. Showdown means an argument regarding this matter. So you never realized how deeply I had hurt me. But physically and mentally. So due to this incident, Tinkori Babu was completely hurt by both mental and as well as physical, as he becomes injured. Oh, he got injury. I didn't know about you till I came to stay in your house and saw your childhood photograph. Okay, he's saying that I did not recognize you once I met you, and I stayed at your home. But while staying at your home, I got your childhood to photo, and then I recognize you, and then I planned all the things. Okay. And then I thought of doing something that would cause you a great deal of anxiety and trouble you for a short time only. My aim is to making you for some time only. After, I don't want to kill you. I don't want to make a big harm to you. I mean to do no harm. This was my way of punishing you for the past sin. Now that is all over, let's forget about it and move on with our lives. With good wishes, yours sincerely, Tinu. Okay, so this was the letter by Tinkori Babu, and he is now talking about all the incident, why he has done all the things. So here the story is finished. Children, I hope that you got the story very well. So if you have any problem, you can ask me. And you have to not write word meaning in your book or in your notebook copy. You can only learn the word meaning from your book. For question answer, I will be giving one more video for this in the next day. So I will be explaining their question answer. So till that time, thank you so much, and have a nice day.